usable space, and their concern was, you know, if they, is it possible to add a small amount of space to make it possible to have a table and chair out there so we have enjoy a dinner outside, and maybe use this as a three-season room. So that is the crux of why I'm here. They felt it important enough to hire an architect and go through this process to make this de minimis addition, if you will. So we came out and measured up the house, and we looked at it. And right now, between the garage and the 2 foot over to this, over this wall here, which is back, yeah, which is right over, over this.
That wall's already there.
The wall, yeah.
It's not going to extend any further than the wall that's already there.
So there's already a 3 foot space.
Right.
And the idea of, you know, coming into, out of an L shape, you know, changing the design, one of the things is we wanted the design to resemble the existing, the same as the existing mass, it's just extruded out just a little bit more to make the interior, you know, work for the
very small, and the immediate neighbor that looks at this thing 24/7 is favorable to it. I'd like to have a favorable approval from the board as well. To redesign it and try and pull things out, push walls back would be very expensive. Not that this is inexpensive endeavor as it is. And ultimately the idea was just to kind of keep the same, you know, look and feel that is there. I mean, ultimately it should be as though that didn't really ever happen. So, and again, I also think that 3 foot clearance between the existing wall which is there and the building now that's coming forward to it is not presenting a hazard for environment or rescue folks.
I would just like to say that when we first designed this house in 2006, it was very important for my husband and me to maintain the look of the original house, which was arts and crafts. Our first architect came up with some wild ultra-modern design, which was very nice, but not fitting for the neighborhood. We wanted to keep the house looking tasteful, and this additional space that we wanted to build on so that we could actually utilize the space better, we wanted to maintain the nice look, not just for ourselves, but for the neighborhood.
You understand, motion's made, it's turned down, you can't come back.
Which means that if you say no, that's it.
For this design. For this design, you have to come back with something that's substantially different. I'm just giving you a heads up.
neighbors there, I'm gonna go to the property line, but my neighbor is ecstatic for me to put paper slip, because this way the stone doesn't pop anymore into the grass area. So I'm asking not for concrete, I'm not asking for asphalt, but just to continue what's there, so that I can drive on that and not have stones on the street, because when it rains, it erodes the stones into the street. If I leave dirt there, it erodes the dirt, it just, no matter what we do there, it just seems, and if I, as Brian told me, I asked him, what else can I do here? Well, just put grass. Well, I can't grow grass if I'm driving over it. Grass, and the grass is the only thing that's gonna stop it from eroding, because the root system will, I don't know what else to do. I mean, the driveway as it sits, whether I put it back with a stone, it erodes into the street and pops into the neighbor. If I put grass, it's not gonna grow.
Do you have a driveway, your neighbor, on the other side of that?
He's on the opposite side of it, so we're not driving the driver.
Yeah, that would be good.
Yeah, I mean, and I have driven, I've been here in this town for over 30 years, I just recently moved here, but you can see that, I understand that some of these drivers have been grandfathered in, they're all connected to one another. Some of them got, you know, I understand. Now this is a new construction, this is what John has been approved to do, and he did follow whatever he was approved. I'm asking now for a solution. I mean, I have a 10-foot driveway that, when literally we drive in with the car, you open the door, it's hitting the house. We need to. The neighbor doesn't have a problem, it's not, I'm not butting up against his house, he has his 5-foot offset from my property line, because that's the way the offset, that side is my 5-foot, this side was the 30 feet. He has the same thing on the other side. You see clearly there on the picture what, and that's it. I don't have a solution to what else we can do with this driveway.
So the neighbor wants it done?
Yes, sir.
Are you expanding the curb cut, or are you leaving that as is?
No, leave it as is. I don't need to expand the curb as any further. It's plenty for my car to go in and out.
And you explain that, now what happens if the neighbor puts a fence on that property line, then what happens?
Nothing, because we're not gonna be, when I open the door to his side, I'm gonna be inside that 13 feet now. Assuming that you guys will grant me permission, I'm not gonna be this side, I'm not gonna be this, and I'm gonna be in the middle of the driveway, which that would be the good thing, you know. He doesn't have a fence, we have a fence between me and him, but only in our backyards. It doesn't extend to the street. And according to George, the fence there could not be a full height fence anyway. But
no, it could still be a 4-foot fence to the front.
I understand, but yeah, the answer to your question is, yeah, we wouldn't be driving too much, because I don't, you know, we.
Well,
poured a clean stone, and I removed that stone, was not aware that we needed to do this, and I removed the stone, and I was getting ready to put pavers down.
On top of that, yeah.
On top of that, I was gonna fix that, and I was gonna put.
You weren't aware of the 3-foot buffer.
Correct. And then that's when Brian had approached me and told me, hey, you know.
What was there, with this driveway was put in, what was there before? This stone driveway was put there, was it concrete pads, bricks, asphalt?
No, this is a brand new construction.
Brand new,
oh, I'm sorry.
Brand new construction.
Oh.
Brand new house.
I definitely see the need to remedy this situation. At the same time, I'm a little curious on how it came about. Were these variances to begin with to build these two houses where they are?
No, they,
or was it that narrow because?
I don't know for sure, but I don't believe this was an application before.
Okay.
I think that they were granted building permits.
And
that's all I know.
So
and the driveway was just overlooked.
I don't ever recall this being at the board. Now, maybe it was before I was here. I've been here five.
This was in front of this board.
It was?
But this fits the driveway of 10 feet, fits toward the code.
They were just built. So why would they have to build a driveway?
The problem is the driveway is a little narrower than 10 feet, and it's right up against the structure.
Right.
So you lose even a little bit more.
So to get a bigger house, essentially, they made a narrow driveway?
I don't know how the reasoning is that they got here, but they got here because I guess it was looked at where they met all of them. They didn't need any variances.
Right.
So they were given their permit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This is too
close. Would it be possible to remedy this and give everyone what they need by granting a little more of a buffer than 3 inches?
Well,
because if this is put forth the way it's asked, we're given a 3-inch.
No, 6-inch.
Six inches.
It would
from
be
the property line.
The new driveway would be 6 inches from the property
line. In pavers, not. I'm not asking you.
No, I understand, but then you've got runoff issues, snow issues, and I know your neighbor's okay now. But
the next
goes away, and fence goes up, and then it becomes. Now, this like it's a long term.
This is another situation where I need to say that I have been by the property and I've seen this situation, and I really can't see the expansion of the driveway over to that space as ever being seen as a negative to the neighbor, to the east.
As being?
I can't see where it would be. No, I don't see I really don't see a downside. You know,
if anything, it would actually improve.
Yeah.
It's not going to butt up to another driveway. It's
right.
Butt up to the grass.
Mm-hmm.
And whether my neighbor ever sells that house or not sells the house, puts the fence, it really should never be a negative in any way, shape, or form.
The problem is you hate to see a driveway to the property.
I'm
not asking for the property line.
It's 6 inches,
okay.
Yes.
Okay, so you still got 6 inches.
And then when you're really door, and step out, you're on the next.
So
when you,
how much do you really need to open the door? The whole thing?
I would like to.
I didn't say
I would say I would need at least 2 feet. So I'm asking for 2.5 because right now what's there is 3 feet from the property to the existing neighbor. There's 3 feet, and I'm asking to go 2.5. If it's really that big of a deal, I'd like to have the 2 feet because the picture actually shows my truck, and you can see where my tire is.
But
there's
no,
it's still
okay.
Yeah.
And there's room against the house, but if I open up the doors, I'm
it property is what it is, and that's a bottom line. Property is what it is.
Gotcha.
You knew that when you built it. You put the house where it was, so there was no consideration given to all that. But that's here or there. But now we're trying to fix it. Now we're trying to come to a solution.
You have a clear parking spot from the curb to your house, like a one-car parking spot, clear.
Well,
are we looking to eliminate on-street parking? So this whole strip is, but that's not a usable piece. So granting.
Less than 10 feet, then the curb cut is a little bit less than 10 feet.
Just driveway right in some, basically in somebody's property line. It's fine right now, today's day, right now, 10 years from now, I don't know. Opening the door, but as you get out of the car, you're going to be on the guy's property.
We all don't know if we're going to be here tomorrow.
When you snow, when
the
driveway goes, you make snow.
The house will be here after us.
When
yeah.
you with snows, you plow the snow.
And I'm saying that I don't feel that that is, I'm asking you guys
please,
to share my opinion that
Sharon,
it is.
Can I just ask a question? If you left a foot off the property line, would that give you enough?
Well, that's what I just, when he asked me, I would say, okay, a foot. Because it's 6 inches, now I'll say another 6 inches, it becomes a foot.
It's gotta be a buffer of some sort, like something handy.
It's a foot.
Inches, but foot.
So, I mean, is that something that everyone
I think
would,
that might.
Yeah. What are you going to do as far as stopping the erosion?
Well, then, at that point, from that foot,
you know, refill it.
I would, no, I would put sod down, and obviously.
Right, no pavers to the edge.
No. Well, if you guys tell me no, obviously. I would fill what you guys allow me to do, which is, if, let's say, 2 feet. I'm asking 2.5, but if you're saying 2 feet, then I would do the 2 feet, and that last foot I would do with grass. And I would do my darn best to keep my truck off of it so that we can grow grass there.
And that would be in line with the curb cut?
Yeah, you want to go ahead with the curb cut, yeah. That's it right there.
So you would have to request the change of...
We could. First request the change.
I request a change for 2 feet, please.
And leave a foot.
Leave a foot from the property
with
line.
With grass.
Yes.
So
it's actually going to be that foot of grass plus his...
No,
my foot.
We're only worried about your piece of property.
Yes. 1 foot of grass, yes, sir.
Okay. Anybody else on the board?
Yeah. Is it clear what you plan to do in the back of the house with the pavers? Because it does say you need a variance for this patio in the back. What is actually going on back there? It's like a mix of old and new pavers.
I took a permit for that. What happened was, in the back of the house, there's a deck off of my back door. And the pavers were just a walkway. And I was getting weeds underneath my deck. And I filled that in with pavers. But I took out a permit, and I was granted a permit for that.
Why is that on your application?
I don't know. There was a confusion about that, but that there shouldn't be. I provided the impervious quantities, and everything is in there, and I meet that. So.
Did you have it in your report?
Yeah, the issue where we picked it up is in the back corner. It's violating the side yard setback. So if you see where the 1.07 is on the survey,
yeah.
Okay, there's a new paver area in there.
Yeah.
Okay, that needs
street, like Paris. So I mean, I'd like to see the Duzzevo lot line too, or at least give him the 6 inches that he requested. I mean, it's a busy street, and you could fit 3 cars in that park. And he's correct, 303 Fourth Avenue was a brand new house that was built by the builder, and he didn't give 11 feet, he gave 10. And they came in here, and they got relief for 1 foot. The house should have been moved, you know. But we gave them the relief, and all he's asking for is, I think you should allow him to have the 2.5 feet, if possible. Thank you.
The other thing is that I'm gonna have to maintain that 1 foot of grass.
Yeah.
Before we say that, I'll make a comment. See, we have the chairman of the